All right. Well, it's been a long time coming, but I'm finally here on this. What are my thoughts on Foo Fighters' debut album? Ladies and gents in Cyberland, coming back to you with another album review. This time we're moving on to a band that I feel kind of still keeps grunge alive to an extent, but also has other elements as well. Foo Fighters. So, I first heard Foo Fighters from a song called Big Me. I remember I was hanging out with some old friends, and I saw the video, and I was just like, you know, for some reason people really liked the song. I was just like, okay, whatever, you know, I didn't feel anything about it. And I heard The Color and the Shape. I heard a couple songs. Really, Monkey Wrench really got me into the band. People will say Everlong, but no, Everlong didn't get my attention. It was Monkey Wrench. Monkey Wrench just blew me away. The video was amazing. The song was great. And I went and got the album. And at first, I was kind of like, yeah, whatever. I was like, oh, I just like Monkey Wrench and a couple songs. Well, it's not that great, but it really is. And during that time, because I remember it was around my ninth grade, my freshman year, and I'm finding all these bands little by little. You know, you're getting Green Day and 311 and a little bit of Metallica, and Korn is on its way, but not here just yet. So I'm finding myself with, and then Smashing Pumpkins to some degree. So I'm finding myself, and I actually got into Nirvana, and I'll eventually get to those reviews at some point. And I was listening to Monkey Wrench, or I was listening to The Color and Shape, and I looked at the guy, and I was like, wait a minute. I don't know, but this guy looks so familiar. Because I had Nirvana's Nevermind, but it wasn't mine, but it became mine because nobody claimed it in my mom's house. I think it was one of my mom's old friends that left the album or something, but I was like, I'm going to listen to this. And I noticed the correlation that, wait a minute, the drummer of this band is the singer of this band. Why is that? Of course, I didn't know yet what happened with Nirvana and such. Anyway, at some point, I decided to go back and listen to this album. And for the most part, I was surprised because all I ever heard from this album was Big Me, and I didn't hear anything else. And I went through the album, and it was really good. The sound quality wasn't the greatest, though. And then, of course, finding out why, you know, it wasn't. I guess Dave recorded everything on his own. He did the bass, the drums, the singing, and the guitar. Well, of course, singing and the guitars. It was a one-man show. It was just him by himself. And so I listened to it, and I enjoyed it. And I didn't buy the album probably for the next... I didn't buy this album really probably for the next 15 years. I had it, read between the lines, but I never had a physical copy of it. However, I would just keep listening to it whenever the mood suited me, and I enjoyed it. I thought it was a great album. I just never got around to buying it, and you know. However, I did buy it. So. And looking back on it now, as far as I'm concerned, I think it's one of the best albums that was done by the band, even though technically it was done by Dave, but I just say it's one of the best albums under the Foo Fighters name. How about that? It's very aggressive, very abrasive, and it doesn't let up. I think outside of Big Knee, nothing really lets up on the album. It just goes from one song to another, and For All the Cows and Big Me are probably the only songs that are Big Me is the most chill, and then For All the Cows is the second most chill. But everything else is just like, this is a call, it's abrasive, I'll Stick Around, Weenie Beanie, Exhausted, Ecstatic, Good Grief, Alone, Easy Target, Floaty, you know, everything else was very aggressive. For me, I hold this album in high regard. And I think it's really just because after this album and Color and the Shape, I think Dave started branching out to be not as aggressive at times. Still have aggressive songs, but just not as much as these two. These two, I felt, were the most in-your-face, just hard rock, grunge records compared to the later ones. And that's okay. Just saying what I got from it. My rating for this album is a 10 out of 10, yes, sirs. It's a classic Foo Fighters before the Foo Fighters really started to become what they were. And that's not a bad thing. Just... Pat Smear comes on, Taylor Hawkins comes on, Nate Mendel comes on, Chris Sheffla comes on. Members start coming on into the band. And then recently, in the last couple years, they got a keyboardist. I just forget his name because I just can't remember his name at the moment. My top five tracks are Good Grief, Ecstatic, Alone, Easy Target, This Is a Call, and Floaty. And then I think what also drove, what makes me love the album even more is when I watched the documentary on Back and Forth of Foo Fighters, where how the band started and how it started, unfortunately, and then where it moved up to, and then it went all the way up to Wasting Light. So it doesn't include Sonic Highways or Concrete Gold or Medicine to Midnight. It does include those three, but it has everything. And I really love that documentary because it gives such a great perspective on what happened with these albums being created and the drama of making them and what was going on behind the scenes with them and how some albums were worked on and what issues might have caused with band members with them. Just all those things, and it makes me love them more. I mean, the members may not feel that great about what transpired, but I love the albums more because I know those things and how this song was created and why it was created or what happened. Sometimes the story behind a song, even if it's the artist going for a jog and that's how they came up with the song, that just, to me, that always makes me love the song more because it has a story. It's not just I wrote a couple words and that was it. It's like, it took me a long time for this song to come out because it wasn't ready. But then you factor in everything that the person was doing that ended up becoming what that song is. And especially if you really love it, then you love it even more. So I would say if all you know is the Foo Fighters later stuff, you may not like this because the later stuff is a lot more mellow and more harmonized than the first two albums. So each their own. I love it. I look at it's like if you like Foo Fighters, then check it out. So, with that being said, cue the music.